debut single, Wannabe. And in the first of a two-part Spice special, we catch up with the girls on the road.
Girls really, really do like America. It's full of misfits, so I fit in.
It's been really hectic, but it's been good fun as well. The rest
is on. This is all right, at least it's less, you know. Stylist hates me.
Nobody can understand what we're going through apart from us five, really. But the most difficult thing for us to get our head round and for our families to get their head round is the press. And we don't care. The press can say anything about us. They can camp outside my door. I don't care. It's part of my job. But it's not part of my parents' job. And that makes us angry because, you know, they didn't choose to be in this profession. They've got normal jobs. They go to the office 9 to 5. Do you know what I mean? So why should they have their picture in the paper? Why should they be followed going shopping? I think it's disgusting. The British press should sort their lives out. No one wants to see it anyway. It's boring.
Probably had the easiest ride out of everybody. I mean, I haven't really got a past, you know, not really a hell of a lot interesting they can say about me. Or do I trust anybody? I'm very wary of a lot, you know, of a lot of people now, which, you know, I think you have to be like that, because there's a lot of people that would like to stab you in the back.
Had such a laugh, what a good vibe. We always, you know, we always get on, and even if you do miss home or you get tired, get through it because you're always laughing, always. I don't think I've stopped laughing all this trip. It's been really cool.
Nice to meet you. Hi, I'm Melanie.
When you're famous, I think you get dehumanised a little bit sometimes.
Like, somebody will come up to you and they'll go, autograph, thank you, right, autograph, and it's
yeah,
like,
and they,
hello.
And they push and pull you and they think that they can do that.
But that's all right, because I'll just deck you next time you do
actually,
to me or my mate.
Do you know something that is quite unfortunate is, you know, you go to all these fantastic countries and all you see is a hotel room, a car and a recording studio.
Hey, you're a Spice Boy. How can you get sick of doing this? It's great. You might get tired and a bit ratty. But apart from that, it's fine.
As if I'd get ratty.
Yeah, nah.
We got drinks here, we got food here. We even got a fine TV crew here. How you doing, guys? Wave, we're on TV. Hey. All the Spice Girls are here. Some are way back there, eating way back there. I got Jerry right here from the Spice Girls. What's up, Jerry?
Hello, new kids. Hi, so tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
Yeah, oh, he wants to know what you're wearing.
I'll leave it to your imagination.
They are looking very, very hot.
We realised that when we came to America, you know, we really had to start from the beginning. Obviously, we've done well in Europe and Asia, but, you know, we realised that we really had to start from scratch with America. It's not going to be easy, but, you know, it's a big country and it's going to take a lot of work.
Excuse me, you're going to have to leave. Out. Thank you.
Well, that's okay. He's not allowed in here, and he's not allowed to take photos if you're professional. And you're not allowed to take any photographs. He's not allowed to... Well, it doesn't matter. He's not allowed to take any photographs. Okay? No photos. Okay,
hello.
Right.
Hello! Spice Girls are on the
Empire
State Building.
Hello!
Hi, baby!
Isn't this where we meet Tom Hanks?
We had him...
Yes, we were waiting for him.
And King Kong.
This is it, isn't it?
Right, basically, we're going to have all five of you up here.
Climb up where? Oh, Bill's sick already.
Children, don't try this at home.
The rule is, look at the helicopter. The helicopter's going to come in over there from the left.
I've never heard of them. I don't know who they are.
a music group or something?
Do they dance when they sing?
Be my lover. You gotta get to be my friend. You do me forever. Touch me never end.
Five boys over there. We like that.
Yo, tell me what I want, what I really, really want.
Don't tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
We're doing like 12 or 13 radio interviews in a morning. And like, obviously GMTV were with us this morning, and not all of them are as smooth as, you know, you hope.
Hey. Hello.
What's going on over there?
We're having a party.
Your single has gone triple platinum. Why not have a party? You guys deserve it. You're kicking ass. You're like number
kicking
one.
Kicking ass. I'm kicking ass.
For some reason, like, a lot of the male DJs, all they want to do is talk about sex, you know, and at the end of the day, do you know what I mean? We just want to have a laugh. And you can really take the pee out of them, and they don't even realize sometimes. So.
Do you guys like go to bars and pick up guys and stuff?
No.
Why
no.
Why not? You're not into guys?
Yeah, oh, but I've got a fella at home. Have you, Mel?
Yeah, I've got a fella at home.
We've got fellas at home as well.
You all have fellows?
No,
fellows.
Fellows.
Jerry haven't.
Yeah, we haven't. So we're looking out in a minute.
But to be honest, what breed of guy can you pick up from a bar anyway, apart from a dirty drunk?
No.
Some of the, you know, the DJs have been really chauvinistic, you know, but in a way that's a bit of a challenge for us lot, you know, to battle that out, you know, educate them and say, look, you know, maybe that's all they've had an easy ride, basically, you know, coming across girls that have been dominated. But hopefully we can show, look, girls, you know, and even confronting these DJs, we're not taking any of their, you know, all the crap that they throw at us.
We don't need men to control our lives. We control our lives anyway.
Yeah.
I'm saying, pick up some American men who you can control.
No.
All right.
We don't want to control you.
What? You need controlling then, speaking on behalf of American men, do you?
What's more power
because
than that?
Because we'll happily come down there to Seattle and educate you, right? On girl power.
Yeah, we'll tell you about not being a 90s man, you know, because we girls have got balls.
If you want to be my
rock the world. And wow.